we are just trying to add on something which is called a user, and then turning the user into a participant, and then see how that participant gets a notification. So that is a thing that we will be doing. This is the dashboard, everyone, and the advertisements, they do remain every time we do this. Let me go to site administration. This is the course, the site. Available courses are this one and public speaking. So let me add a student to this course only, because we have added a quiz here so that the quiz can be attempted by a student. Now this is this. Now if I go to add a participant to this, let me click on participant and see, I have added these two people, and I believe the people are going to respond soon. If the people have got some email, please let me know. If you can share your screen, I can guide you. Enroll the users. Now here, yes, here it is. Here is this name called Eklavya Sharma. ParveenWrites@gmail.com. Let me send an email to this. Please let me know. What I'm doing is I'm enrolling a participant. Now, let me start again from the beginning. That way, if you people have got a doubt, is there anyone who wants me to demonstrate how to add a user? After fetching questions from question bank for quiz, what is the next step? Go to the quiz module, Rajeshwari ji. And after that thing, in the quiz module, you click on it and edit quiz, and then click on add question from question bank. Can we enroll students without uploading CSV format? Dr. Uma, this is what I wanted to get a hint. There are two questions I'm responding at present, how the students will access and how we can upload them without CSV. Let's do it from the beginning. From the beginning means, if you are not uploading them through a CSV, can you upload them individually without a CSV? I'm going to site administration, everyone. I'm going to users. I'm going to add user. Please see, I'm going to add user. I click on add user, add a new user that way. But before that, let me delete that previous email, because one email will be adding again. I'll delete myself as my alternative email ID from the user list. Here it is. I'm deleting it for now, so that I can add this email ID again as a user. Now that thing doesn't appear here, and these people were added previously. Now let me go to site administration. How to add an individual as a user? Individually, can you add them? Site admin. In the site admin, let us go to users. Let us go to add a new user. Then give a username. Let me give a username means suggest me a username. Okay, CCW resource person 1, CCW RP 1. Manual account, generate the password and notify the user. Yes, I want that automatically it should generate a password and it will notify the user. I can make a password here also. I can make a password here, but what I'm choosing is I'm deciding that automatically a password should be generated and there should be a force password change. But this force password change, dear teachers, will happen only when I'm giving a password. Suppose what I'm doing, I am making a password. First, I will unselect it. Here, I'm making a password in front of you. And the password I'm making is 12345678 9. So this is the password that I have made. But password must have at least 8 characters, 1 digit. So that way, this password is going to be accepted by them or not. Let us see. Or let me make it CCW123. So I inform everyone, your username list is, username will be coming, and by default this is the password. Who is the first name? The first name is test, second name is teacher, email addresses. This is the email address that I am adding. Now, city and town and all these things. Okay, nahi, I'm just going to change the time zone, and that helps us. Time zone should be changed for everyone. Let me go to AK. Here we are, AK. Select a country, Iceland and India. That's it. And then description I'm not giving. I'm not adding user picture, and then creating a user. The user, what says password must be 8 characters, one uppercase, one this. See, this error is there. Now, let me make it C capital. All other things remain the same. Can the user be created now? No, password must have one, minimum 8 characters. 3 plus 3, 4 and 5. We need to keep in mind if these conditions are there, then we need to be very alert about it. Now, what do we need? We need another feature. Now, CCW12345 is the password that I am sharing with you. So, here is the password, everyone. This is the password. I can hide it now. Let us see. User. 10 new users. Now, can I see this user that I created? Yeah, here it is. Test teacher. I'm a user. Now, if I am a user, then being a user, what thing that I shall be doing or you shall be doing is, the test teacher account is there. So let us see whether I can log in just as a user. What was the CCWRP1, and what was the password, everyone? Here is the password. Copy, paste. I am logging in as a user, and you can see I just logged in as a user. These were the password details I had were being set by me. Like a student comes to you, and while sitting in your laboratory cabin or office, you can simply tell them, okay, fine, I'm adding you as a user, and this is your username and password. I'm telling you, the email might take some time because it is going to come from Genomio. You can personally tell them, current password is what? Current is this one. New password, everyone, is CCW. Why would I tell you? So I have changed the password. Oh, the first one goes lowercase. One lowercase, one uppercase, one symbol. Okay, this is test teacher, everyone. Please see, this is the student account I'm showing you. I'm showing you the student account, and this student has not been enrolled in any course. That way, two online users, last 5 minute test teacher, and this I can see. And this person who is a user of the site does have the site address. This is the course, available courses. Can you see? You cannot enroll yourself in course. You cannot enroll yourself in course. I repeat, you cannot enroll yourself in this course. I'll say continue. Nothing. Click here again. Means a student can log in, but a student cannot access the course. So when you will add them, only then they will be able to access the course. Meanwhile, they can see all the announcements, all the introductory thing here, like Kaveri College and public speaking. If I try to enter public speaking, it says you cannot enroll. Now, let me do one thing. I am opening an incognito window where I will manage the admin controls. We will add this person as a student, and you will see the changes have happened. Please let me know if you people have understood how I have added the manual user. And if you people have already done it, the five people you have added, as we people had thought of, they must have received it, or you can convey the username and password to them. What is the difference between participant and a user? There's a big difference. A user is a site presence. I have been insisting This question should be shuffled as what is the difference between a user and a participant rather than a participant and as user. So what I'm doing is first you add them as a user on the site, they can log in, and later on you can add them to different courses or subjects. Like you people have got students in your college. Everyone is not a student of mathematics. Everyone is not a student of English. So you keep everyone on the Moodle site, but you allot them their own subjects, their own courses. So this is what I can say. A participant is a participant in a course, and a user is a member of the Moodle site. What is Cognito window? In Cognito window, Control Shift plus N. This is what I press. It means it's a new window which will not share my history, and I don't need to sign out from the previous one. Sometimes it happens that someone comes and says, "I want to use your browser," and the person signs out from everywhere. So if I go to an incognito window, then I don't need to do anything. While uploading new user password should be doctor, there is a different format for it in which password is also given in advance, but we are not learning that for today. There is just one column to be added as participant, as password. So I'm not doing it. I prefer that Moodle should send an automatic password to them rather than I make a password for them, because ultimately we want them to change the password. So this is what we should be doing. And while uploading user, new user password should be, if you know, when you're using the format that we have discussed, please click on automatically generate a password. No, okay, special character. Yeah, you people were like helping me out. I didn't see that. Good. Okay, now let me go to, now this is the student end, and this is the teacher or the course owner who's logging in. I am logging in with in the same thing that you people had been looking at for the last 1.5 day, but the test teacher has been seen by you just now, and the test teacher we have seen was added as a user, but the test teacher is not able to do anything. You see, test teacher can do all the things. The student can change the profile. This person is added as a student. He can see, the student can see primarily what courses are there, but the student cannot enter the courses unless the student is enrolled in a course. So this is what I have done. What I'm doing now, I'm going to my site home and going to my course. To which course you want this student to be added? You want them to be added to CCW, or you want them to be added to public speaking? Please respond in the chat. Where should I add this person, the user test teacher, as a student, like, to which course? CCW or public speaking? Please suggest where should a CCW. Okay, Ramaji, I'm going with the CCW thing. See, this is test teacher. Here we are adding it. Like, why do you say test teacher? Someone says, sir, ma'am, you have typed my name in a different way. I need to do that thing. So what do? They say, is one of my students, a very loving student though, sharing his, now he changed. This student has changed, Sultan Rashid. So he changed, and then means this is possible. You can make it, username should not be changed, otherwise this is student who has changed. Now let me move on to the teacher control. This is the teacher control. You can see my picture here. Which course? CCW. I'm going to CCW. I know this user is a member of my site. So I go to participant. These are the two participants. Let me go to enroll users. Let me go to selection. Let me search for this, where it is. See, this change is here. The name was changed. Email ID is here. Enroll the selected user. Selected user is getting enrolled where CCW, and I minimize it. I refresh. And this person will have entry into CCW now. See, can you see the course has appeared here? For this person, the course has appeared. This is Sultan Rashid, the student. The course has appeared. So if you have already now, if you make your student users and then also add them as participants quickly, so and then tell them that they have been enrolled in a course also, so they can do this thing. So here it is. Now you can see all the things are available for the student. Let me do this thing now. Announcement. Sultan Rashid is opening announcements, everyone. There is no nothing. The announcements are not there, so nothing can be done. Otherwise, this person would have been able to respond to it. Let me go to quiz trial introductory. Who is doing it? The student. And who is going to view it? The teacher. Attempt the quiz. 5 minutes. 2 attempts allowed. Attempt the quiz. Start the attempt by Sultan Rashid student. Okay. True. Music. It is Sunday. It is CCW. It is education. Name of the school. Finish the attempt. Very quick. Answer, answer. Save, save. Return to attempt. Still 4 minutes left. I'm returning. I'm changing it to Moodle. Finish the attempt. Final submission to be done now. Submit all and finish. Submit all and finish. You can see this is the result and this is the feedback I have got. Okay, doesn't matter because we are just trying. Finish the review. The student has reviewed it. Can you see this thing? And what is this? Sultan Rashid. Reattempt the quiz. I'm reattempting the quiz now. Earlier, the marks are 9.17 because partial grades were like decided by all of us. Now, if it is 9.7 and I am making this attempt again, 2 attempts were allowed by us, and let us see what comes, the average, the highest, or something. Now, see, this has come correct. False is correct. This is what we had added. Finish the review. And can you see this, everyone? Marks for 11 and 5, grade 9.7 and 4.7. So this is what it is. This, your final grade is this because the quiz said we'll take highest grade. Now this is the student one. Let us go to the teacher. What teacher has got? Teacher will go to her own course and will see this quiz and will open this quiz. This is teacher, everyone. Teacher says attempts to something. Then the teacher says there is something in progress. Now teacher is attempts are two. So teacher will find it this way. Like teacher will is going to find it this way. Teacher will go to grades and find the quiz has been attempted. And if the quiz has been attempted, then it becomes quite easy. Okay. Now, what is this? This is grades. I'm going to the grades now, and I can you see this thing? These are 2 attempts done by the student, and these are there with me. I can download this as in these formats. This performance of the all the students can do this. I can regrade everyone. Page size means 30 students can be displayed. This is the score. This is the chart we have got. Chart data can also be shown to you. Like from this grade to this grade, these are the people who are there in your class. So this is happening. And I can see which question was done by the student. I can review it. See, this question opens. I can see that the question was completed. The quiz was done at this time. And this is what I can do. The student started at 2:53. The student did this first, saved false, and then attempt finished correct. So these are the things which are there. Close this window. You can review everything that the student has done. See this, and the timings are there. Not yet answered, answered, incorrect. So these things are there. This is the student, this is the teacher segment. I'm going to grades now. You know that I've got 3 students. Out of them, only one has attempted. So I can see this. Quiz 2 is there and course total is there. Not done. I'm going to quiz 2 now. The quiz 2 is when I go to the course, means I'm a student. I log in and I see all this thing. I go to another quiz that my teacher has placed. And if restrictions are there as a student, I will not be able to open it. So I go here. I attempt this 3 minutes quiz. But the format says that only one question will appear on each page. I am not reading the options, everyone, not in the even the questions. So I'm just moving on just to see how this thing appears to the teacher who is running the course, who is the course creator. I'm going to return to the attempt. No, I'm going to submit and finish this time. Now, this is the result, everyone. Very poor result. Finish the review. Grading method highest. Attempts not listed. It means I can take as many attempts as I want. So I'm taking second attempt. Fine. I decide to go to number 5. Select this and finish. I have skipped questions because this navigation pane is going to be. I'm sharing with you the student side, please. This navigation pane allows me to move. Navigate from the beginning to the end one by one rather than clicking on next. Now, this is my performance, only one is correct. Still, let me go to the teacher side, refresh, and let us see. Student number 2 has been able to do something. You can see 2, and this is the average, everyone. Now, I click on Sultan Rashid and I see that this person needs a message. So I click on the name of the student, either it is from the grades or from the participant segment. I click on message. And this is online. Why this is online? Because this person is online in a different way. Okay, one person is there who has sent me a message on our day. Hello, you need to collect certificate. Send. The message has been sent by Virtual Teaching 2020 to whom? To Sultan Rashid. Now, these are the messages that I have just received from someone. Person is offline because they dropped me this message when the course was running and they were added as you say students. Now, this is Sultan Rashid. A message has been dropped by the teacher. And can you see this pop-up? One, if you can see it, please type yes. If you cannot see a pop-up one near the name of the student that a message was sent and you know what message it was. I'm not opening it. I first want to see whether you can see it. Now I'm looking at the chat. Okay, you can see. Thank you. Now I am clicking here and this is the message which has come from the student, from the teacher to the student. I'll tell you how you can send messages in bulk. Like you can select all of them and send them the same message. Let's go. You need to collect the certificate. Okay, now this is student portal. Let me go to the teacher portal. Teacher portal is here. Let me go to my course. The course is the one in which this student was enrolled. I'll go to participants. All the participants will get listed, everyone. You can see I can select all. Can you see this? I can select all. I went to participant. I select all. What selected users? What to do? This is the option. I can edit. I can delete. I can allow them to self-enroll. But I'll go to send a message. We are learning well or not. What I'll do, I'll share with you all a small, like some people asked that how is it possible that we can collect data from the students? Like how will we do that? Simple, make a simple Google form which has got first name, last name, email ID, mobile number and something, and then select only those three, four options which are there. Let the, you give them a roll number or a username of your choice. Like you can make it student one, or you say a department code is there or something. You do that. You delete their mobile number while making a CSV, and then you upload that. So Google Form can be there. Now what we have done is I have dropped a message to everyone. Now let me go to Sultan Rashid. A message was being sent, I guess. Let me see whether I no message is there. Okay, new message again. So these two people, Sabita ji and Abhinay ji, you are going to get so many messages because we are just testing. Refresh. Why I'm refreshing? Because the page might have got idle. You can see there's a message here. New message again. Two messages are there, in fact. So messages are, we are learning well or not, new message again, and this is what we are doing by going to participants. So you can communicate with them. See, chat is there for live interaction. Then we have got message also, we have got forum also. These things are there. So now which one you click, sir, to send message? What I did, ma'am, I went to participants. Let me go to participants. I went to participants. Now these are the participants to whom I want to send a message. If I want to send a message to this person only, I will simply select one and decide send message. One only. Send message to one person. Please keep eye on the full screen that I am sharing. I'm sharing with you a complete screen. Something on the left side is blue. Blue means this is the option which is open. I want to send a message to all of them. I can select all, deselect all. Okay, select all, or I can select all with A and all with B and all with C. This is the sorting option. So I can select all and choose send a message. The message has been sent. Can I request these two people, Abhinay ji and Sabita? These two people have shared their email IDs. Have they haven't logged in. I can see this. Never and never. The people have got their username and passwords. If the people haven't got an email, please let me know. I can share with you a password so that you can log in. Everyone, this is Sultan Rashid. Let me see whether this student can see who all are there in the course or who are logged in. Can you see this? This is customizing this page option is there. Now, can you see everyone? If this would have been a face-to-face thing, I would have asked you people to clap. Like, we have got a new student enrolled. I can see there are three online users. One is teacher and two are there, and these people have got some messages. I can send a message to this classmate of mine. This is a message. Hello. So and so to another. Now this is a chat. This is a messaging going on between the student. This is what like students do. Okay, someone has said good. Message has been sent to you. You can reply. This message is gone. Let me see whether your login information has reached. Yes, everyone, you can see 16 seconds. And let me tell you where this user has gone. I'm clicking, I'm on participant. I click on Abhinay. Yes. And if this student won't tell me the IP address is there. Last access is this. These are all the things, the certificates of the student, the grading and everything is there. I'm not checking. Role is also mentioned. Course is also mentioned, to which course, multiple courses will be listed. And I am going to all logs. You know what is log? Log is the record. Now I can tell you what has been accessed by this. Abhinay ji, can you unmute yourself? Can you please unmute so that you can hear me and we can hear you? So can you do one thing? Can you just confirm you have done these things, the things which are on the screen? Can you verify to everyone that
Yes,
you are
sir.
actually accessing these? And I'm telling you. So we have your user history. At what time you did what?
Yes, sir. Yes. Yep.
Is it true?
Yeah, sir. Just I was accessing through my mobile. So.
So are these the things that you are accessing?
Yes, sir.
Quiz attempt started. So you did this quiz, you did this. So thank you, ma'am.
Okay, sir.
Right, ma'am.
Thank you.
Okay, you can mute. See everyone, there are 11 hits by this user. I can see. I can do like the logging thing. These are the activities. This user has done this event. The event name is this. These are the things. Some IP address was this, is used through the web. So these things are possible. Like this is a monitoring or a supervision that we people will be doing over the students. This is Mr. Teacher who is able to see. Now, this is what it is. Let me see. Quiz. Three attempts have been done, everyone. I'm clicking on three attempts. Now, these are the three attempts. You can see this. Two attempts were done by these, and three attempts. These two are the final ones because we said highest grade. I can select and I can. Where is the delete option? Delete selected attempts. Now, I told you that you can edit a quiz only after deleting. So, how you can delete? You can delete by going to the quiz. As a teacher, you go to the quiz. Suppose I click here, I go to the quiz. I will see how many attempts have been done. See, I deleted one, so there are two only. So I clicked on two. I can see there are two attempts only. Let's do this thing now. Be on the plugins. Let me go back to the presentations now. And in the presentation, I'll tell you what you do. When you people are here in this segment of plugins, don't do anything beyond plugins, even if you see something on my screen. Now I'm opening this thing for you. When you people are in the plugins, you will be clicking on the very first one, which is the very first option is there. That is about, I guess, manage plugins, probably. I think so. It is manage plugins that I clicked. Yeah, manage activities. It is manage activities. It is manage activities rather than say, I'll put it here also so that I don't miss when we people are working on that thing. So we are working on manage activities now. When you click on manage activities, everyone, what you will find is you will find that there is a list of different plugins being. Plugins are some applications and softwares. Some eyes are blue, some eyes are gray. Some eyes are blue, some eyes are gray. Those who are gray, they are not visible to you when you go to add activity and resources. So if you want to activate them, you have to open that eye. So what I want you people to do is that now, see, assignment is shown, hide and show. Attendance is shown here. Suppose I say attendance is off, so attendance goes away. Like attendance is hidden now. Big blue button, there is no use activating it. This is what it is used for live classes, but it is not being supported. It's a paid thing now, so we don't generally use it. A book is active, chat is active, choice is active. We don't use it. Custom certificate is active. I'm not discussing this thing with you at present. Now, Hotpot is active. I'm not talking about Hotpot, needs slightly more time, but I'll be talking about H5P. H5P is somewhere here, which is activated. I from my side activated. Let me see. Yeah, here it is. Everyone, interactive content. Go to where you are going. You're going to site admin, plugins, activities, manage activities. Go to manage activities and reach for two things only. What are you doing? Thank you, ma'am. I want someone like to drop me a message on in the chat also if the people are doing it. What we are doing, we are going to site admin. In the site admin plugins, in the manage activities, ma'am. If you are doing it, please just let me know whether you are able to do it. Site admin plugins, manage activities. In the
So, do
manage
you want to
activity,
share my screen?
after this, ma'am, first you do it, activate it. I want to see whether these things have appeared. So I want everyone to activate only. There is one thing which is called attendance, a green one. You are going to activate attendance. See, I am activating attendance. It will turn blue from gray. It will turn blue from gray. Attendance is done. There is another one which is called interactive content. Please see interactive content. I want everyone to go for interactive content, which is a black thing. And there's an icon which is called black. It is written H5P. H5P. Please go to H5P interactive content and attendance. Attendance was not in our plan though, but I'm tempted, as I was tempted in the last workshop also. I wish that I can share this thing also. This and attendance. So these two are the things that I'll be working now. Let me go back to the site. Interactive content activated. Jitsi, JClick, and all these things are the features, everyone. These are the things I wish that you people explore. This is the quiz. There are more quiz ventures and real-time quizzes and so many other. Certificate generation is also there, dear friends. But that thing can be like explored by you, and that is quite easy. Like, this is about like if you can make one chapati, if you can make one cup of tea, if you can walk 1 kilometer, 1 mile, then you can walk the second mile yourself. Moodle is that kind of thing. So I have activated it. Let me go back to my site, and you will see. Let me go to my course. I'm going to Kaveri College for Women VT workshop. This is the course, everyone. I'm going to my topic. Oh, I have not activated the editing thing. Turn editing on. This is here, and this is here. So attendance, let's, okay, we don't take attendance. Like, if you want your attendance to be taken in every topic, let's add it here once. Everyone, can you see I'm adding attendance? Can you drop a message? Attendance is visible now. And if for you also it is visible, then you can also add it. Otherwise, go to site admin, plugins, manage activities, and go to attendance and turn it blue. Show. Add. I am adding attendance. When I'm adding attendance, I am going to name it as topic one attendance. Topic one attendance. You can make it session one. Suppose I name this attendance as session one attendance. There is no grade here. I'm not changing any other thing in it. I'm just adding it. See, this thing is again same photos and everything, description thing. I'm adding the module. After adding the module, I can change the module into something. Session one attendance. I'm going to attendance now. See, this is attendance. There is no session being added by me. This is I went to topic. This is session one attendance. In topic two, you can name it anything. Like, this is just a test from our side. No attendance is shown here because there is nothing. So let me go to add session, because after all, a class has to be scheduled to mark attendance. When the class is scheduled, this is 12-5 May from, and this is the last thing before we move on for a break for 15-20 minutes. The class is at 3. So this is 3. This is 25. From the class will start from 3:25 to 3:35, 10 minutes class. Now, is the class will happen every day? Yes. Repeat the sessions on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday. Repeat every 1 week. Okay. Repeat until, means my course is going to end in June. So till June, on every selected day that I have done, it will appear. And then students can record their own attendance. No, only the teacher will mark. Add. Now you will see what I'm going to show you. Can you see the names here? No, this is the calendar which has got generated for Tuesday, Wednesday, Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday, because see, Monday is gone. So today is Tuesday. So by default, it is there. If I click on this play button, I can mark the attendance of my students. These are the students, but can you see I can mark it? You say, no, this is gray. What is the time? 3:23. So give me 2 more minutes to revise it. And at 3:25, you will see I'm marking the attendance. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to show it to you again, and then we'll leave you for a 20 minutes break. And then you can come up with the queries that you have. Meanwhile, I will send you all the things that we have done. The brief I will be sending you. What I did, everyone, I went to my course. Suppose this is the attendance. Let me add. I went to anywhere I can go to add activity, attendance, add, added. Now attendance two. Suppose I make it at attendance two. You can name it. This description is two. Nothing changed. Keeping it the same. Now, this is the attendance module, everyone. Let me click here. Now I can make changes to it. Now I can make changes to it. Please be clear. Now, without adding the session, I repeat, without adding a session, you cannot mark attendance. Obviously, you cannot do. So I click on add a session. The session will be on 12th of May, but the time will be 3:45. 3:40. Yeah, okay, 3:42. It will be 3:50. We are making it like 10-minute sessions or so, like session for NG English intro. Suppose now multiple sessions, you'll say no, this session will happen only once at this particular time. I'll say no, repeat it on every Friday till, I'll say till. We'll say 17th of May. This is 12, so 5 days. The moment I will add, I'm not giving permission to the students to record their own attendance. The teacher will mark. Otherwise, they can also open their app and they will get attendance. Now, can you see this? I said till 17th. Till 17th, there is only one Friday. I can click on this play button and I can see that the list of the students has appeared. I can mark the attendance. Why I can mark the attendance now, you see? All present. Set for all users. So I'll say Sabita ji is present. This is present. This is present. I can remark. Exception is also there and absent is also there. And these things are there. You can see like what excused is there. Absent is there. Late is there. Present is there. So if you mark them present, save their attendance. 3:40. Intro, because time frame was not being set, so we can easily mark it for the future date. Now, how can this be blocked that way? Why the teacher is able to mark attendance till the future? Because we did not restrict it. Add a session. Okay, this is what we were doing. Refreshing it. 26. This is the record. I can change attendance. I can see the record also. This is here. I can see 3 present. This way, this attendance plugin is being used. You can try it in the break and then let me know if the student can see something in the course. This is the course for Sultan, and Abhinayji also can see something. See attendance. Open the attendance for this. Okay, attendance 2 is opened, and this student knows 2x2. At present session for English intro, 2x2, 100% attendance. Sessions were 1. Okay, this is here, and these settings you can explore further. Like this is what it is there. Here no attendance marked, but here attendance has been marked. So this is what happens. Why this is 2 is 2? Because we can change the grading or the points also. So these things are there about attendance. And when I'm talking to you, please remember, I have just asked you people to go to plugins, manage activities, and activate what? H5P, INTERACT, interactive content. That's important because once I cover that and you have not activated it, then you might not be able to do it quickly. Attendance icon, I said you will not, you'll find it. Jaya Bharti ji and whosoever says that I have not found it, please share your screen. Other people can go for their break and get back in 15 minutes or 20 minutes. And after that, we'll spend around 45 minutes on covering everything that we have done till now. Over to the people who want to their screen, specifically those who say they have not found attendance icon, please share your screen. Sometimes things are very easy. They are just in front of you and we are not able to see because we are not habitual of the interface of the website. Yes, Jay, please, if someone is sharing. first you see it, what you see, we will see. Go to the left hand side on the top. See, yeah, go here. Yes.
It's okay.
Now, yeah, it is okay. You also need to register your site. We have been insisting since yesterday. Register your site.
Okay.
Go to plugins. Go to, okay, you do it now. Do it. Not a problem. Manage activities.
Here is
attendance. No, you go to this gray icon. One eye. Yeah. No, you went somewhere else, I guess.
This one.
Yeah. Show it. Wait now. Now go to plug. Now scroll down. Go to interactive content. I for interactive. Yes. Go down. Yes. Interactive content. Yes. Absolutely. Interactive. Please check whether you clicked the correct one. Yes, you did. Yeah, perfect. Now get back to your course. Go to the course, industrial microbiology. Okay. Go to add activity and resource. Wherever you want to add your attendance.
Okay, sir. I find out. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. Thank you. This was that easy. But because you people haven't been dealing with the screen every single day, so at present it is tough. So it is better that you allow me to help. Thank you.